Jasleen Kaur, the Braveheart, is joining us from our Delhi studios today. Great to have you, Jasleen. Honored.
Thank
Aditi Mittal, stand-up comedian and writer, speaking up for you. So is Sonia Ashraf. Sanjay Hegde, senior advocate of the Supreme Court. And on the other side today, among those who are concerned, not at Jasleen's case, not just at Jasleen's case, but they feel this trend of using social media to get justice is dangerous. So we have two men who are from the All India Men's Welfare Association, Suresh Ram, and there's Ritwik Bisaria, who's a men's right activist. Vikram Singh, former DGP Uttar Pradesh. Deepika Narayan Bhardwaj says potential of misuse cannot be ruled out, and Kamal Farooqi is a bit of a cynic today. Before I start the debate, I think what you've done is admirable, Jasleen. You could have looked away, you could have pretended it never happened, you could have said, let me try and blur it out of my mind. But you took the picture, you took the challenge, you put the person's picture on Facebook, you gave the motorcycle number, and there he's arrested. My only complaint is, Jasleen, that when he's arrested, his face was covered. I don't know why the police wants to hide his identity when his identity has been revealed everywhere. But tell me, what happened and what made you do what you did?
I've repeated several times what happened. I mean, I just told him that he was going to hit me with his bike because he was crossing the signal. So I just told him that, bhaiya, red light hai. Kyun nikal ke rahe ho? Red light hai. So probably his male ego got hurt. I don't know what happened, but he started hurling abuses at me, and he told me, chal, tujhe zyada problem hai, to aage tak chhod aata hun. And he even got down from his bike and started coming towards me. And when I took out my phone, he went back, he sat on his bike, and he posed for a picture. And he said, haan, chal, main pose
karta hun. Let's take that picture on air, please. One second. I just want that picture on air, please. The picture you took. Can we just have that picture on air? You took that picture. You're saying he actually posed for it.
Yeah, he posed for that picture. And he said, ye le main khud pose kar raha hun, le picture aur complain karke dikha, fir dekhiyo main kya karta hun. So he had the audacity to say that.
Mm-hmm.
He had the audacity to challenge me. I mean, he was at fault. He was being a lech, and he has the audacity to challenge me. This was actually a very perplexing and appalling situation for me. That where am I at fault?
And you also write there in your post, you say that he used, you know, so many obscenities against you. You said, I'm not putting it down out there because I don't want Facebook to remove my post. So he actually went, he went on abusing you even when you were taking him on. And he went on passing vulgar comments and obscenities. Jasleen, and there were people around when all of this was happening. Quite a few people are. It's a busy intersection.
Yeah, there were around 20 to 25 people there, and they were watching what's happening. They were listening to it, but they didn't choose to intervene, and probably because they didn't care, and probably because we have this common perception that it happens. Ye to hota hai. This happens every day. This happens with every girl.
Right.
So just let it be.
Yeah. And then you put this Facebook post, and I mean the response went completely viral.
First I took his picture. I took the picture of his number plate. I lodged a complaint with the police there itself. I waited there for 20 minutes till the PCR arrived. I lodged a complaint, and then I went back home and put this picture on social media.
Right. And what? Tell us about the response after that, briefly. What happened? It just went viral. I mean, it was, by this morning, there were tens of thousands of people who were responding to that one post. You struck a chord.
Earlier, I wasn't expecting that good, that viral response, if you'd like to call that. But definitely now there are around 50,000 shares on that post. So definitely it has got viral, and many people are doubting my intentions to make that post. Well, I want to clarify here, my intention to put that post or put his picture on Facebook was not to gain publicity, as they are saying, or even my intention is not to see that person rot in jail for 7 years. No, I don't want that. I put his picture on Facebook because I wanted to shame this creep. That's it. I wanted him to feel ashamed of himself, and his parents, who are defending him now, they should actually be ashamed of their son, and they shouldn't be defending him now.
And after that, of course, his parents have gone and said things like, she's an Aam Aadmi Party activist, it's political, etc. But I want, you know, Jasleen, I want Aditi, who's sitting here. Aditi, you tell me, why did it go viral? I mean, why are we all here this evening talking about this one instance? You see, it now, the most what people feel, unfortunately, is a commonplace occurrence on the streets of Delhi. Woman gets harassed, gets abused. We look on. It's entertainment. It's the woman's problem. She's going to move on. The fellow is going to get away. But in this, this is so normal that there may be people watching News Hour right now saying, why are they even talking about this? It happens all the time. They have not understood the pulse, the changing pulse of the people, Aditi. That's why we are here today talking about it. Why do you think the issue just exploded? Why do you think people just came out and hundreds of thousands of people are talking about this tonight? Jee, this one case.
Jasleen's story is every Indian girl's story. It is, you know, to want to address what's happening to you, to first of all be made to feel unwelcome, to be reminded of your sexual organs while you're on your way to work. It's so unfair, and it's so alienating in a public space, and it happens to us all the time, to the point that we are immune to it in real life. Is that when we need a graphic description of what happened in order to feel something, and then the defiance of his answer, what he said back in return, you're like, is this the this is the sense of entitlement that has pervaded our streets, and this needs to go. And what Jasleen did, I think that's why the nature, I think right now India is unfortunately or fortunately more caring online than they are offline, as you
Why you
tell.
Say so?
Gee, because there it's easier. It's easier to get to call attention to an issue because the action has to be done by the cops. What needs to be done, that's why there was no, I don't think it was any kind of media trial or social media trial, because it was called to the attention of the cops. It is the job of the police to decide whether he is guilty or not. And that is what they will be doing. And the fact that they paid attention to it is thanks to social media.
And I don't know why it's making some people so insecure today. I just don't understand why. There are some people who say, oh, men are going to be targeted right now. Among those is Ritwik Basaria, men's rights activist. So, by the way, it's an open debate right now. I think what's happening is very, very interesting. There's been an explosion. I believe, though Jasleen has congratulated the police, thanked them for what they have done, I can tell you, Jasleen, we believe the police would have done nothing had you not put it on Facebook, had the media not picked it up, had there not been a public outcry. There is, I can say it with a certain degree of certainty, that the police does not act unless it feels not acting is going to prove to be an embarrassment. Now, let's get the other point of view. Okay, Deepika Narayan Bhardwaj has another point of view. They say that, you know, there are two versions in this case, and there are two versions in every case. Deepika, why don't you open up the debate, and then we'll take the others also into the debate. You, anyone feel free to come in, by the way. We've had two points. Okay, Deepika. Go ahead.
Arnab, I would like to begin from what the opening remarks that you made. I don't think people are, or I am unhappy about these things coming out. What I'm unhappy about is that there is no investigation. You don't wish to hear the other side of the story at all. Right now, when you were talking, I think I was going back to November 2014. And the exact comments that you made right now, Arnab, you made at that time as well. I traveled to the village in Rathak sister's case. The allegations that they had made on channels, I would point out just one thing. They said that their phone was snatched away, right? But in that video itself, which was played on loop, it had in the end the girl saying, "Mera phone dena," but that was not noticed. I'm not saying because of just this one statement should people should not have taken the case seriously or something like that. But Arnab, I wish to ask you that one of those boys, Kuldeep, was not allowed to sit for his army exam, essentially because media picked up this case and hyped it so much that the army said they would not be allowed to sit for the exam. When did you do a show to say that these boys, whatever was alleged on these boys?
So my question to you is, Deepika,
are showing that there is another side of
okay,
the story.
Okay, one at a time. A question put to me.
I was in the previous show as in the
A question put to
show.
Me. Now, Deepika, hear me. Deepika Bhardwaj, hear me.
Yeah.
Hear me. First of all, let us get our facts correct. Let's not put half-truths in this case once again. Three points to you.
Is there a difference between fight and molestation? Please clarify.
Between?
This to me. I wish this
between what and molestation?
Is there a difference between fight and molestation?
Ma'am, it was a verbal molestation.
No, no, what do you mean?
It was a verbal molestation.
You're a woman. How can you talk like that? One second. Yeah, Aditi.
There was no molestation. Passing rude comments at her.
Presenting the other side.
No, no. One second.
Why is she not?
One
why is she not being allowed
second.
To put the
first,
other
Jocelyn,
side?
Jocelyn,
wait a minute.
Jocelyn was responding.
Jocelyn
was responding
to
Deepika.
I understand you, Nan. I hear you. I heard exactly the same things in Rohtak sister's case as well. Until and unless I hear that man also talking, since we are talking over here, so let's...
Ma'am, let me clarify something here. Can I please say something? Arnab, can I please say something?
Yes, please,
you
go ahead.
You are calling him pervert already, Arnab. There's no point of discussion, actually. You have already told him
pervert.
Can I say something?
And we are not concerned or unhappy because people, women are going out in...
Please tell me when you can. When
I with them, I don't think
now Deepika, Deepika Narayan Bhardwaj, Miss Deepika.
But when the other side comes out,
Miss Deepika Narayan Bhardwaj,
you don't show it on your television channel. So there's only one narrative over there.
Just what the other side is.
Can I say something?
I want Jocelyn to speak, please. Jocelyn will speak. First, let Jocelyn speak. Be very clear about the Rohtak case. There is an investigation underway. So if anyone wants to give an impression, including Deepika, that there is no investigation, correct yourself right here. There is an investigation underway. For your kind information, a charge sheet has been filed. The matter is going to court. There is a 200-page charge sheet. So let the investigation conclude. Point number two, Rohtak has nothing to do with Jocelyn.
Point number two, let Jocelyn speak. But can I have every case starting
this is the problem. This is the problem. Deepika, now I've heard you.
But on your show, on your TV channel, there was no witness.
Now you know what you can
on your show or not.
Miss Deepika, you want to go on and on and on about that case? Then I can go on and on and on about the case in which a mob. Listen to me now. Deepika. You have to listen,
like
right?
You get cases.
You have
I
to
get
listen,
so
Deepika.
Cases,
you have to be patient.
Not there in the public
you have
eye.
To be patient. You have to. You listen to me
yeah,
now.
Sorry.
You know you can go yeah, on and sorry. On about cases
sure.
where on the 1st of January 2008, a mob of 60 men openly molested two women outside a 5-star hotel in Mumbai. I can tell you when hundreds of mall goers in Kolkata watched a sales girl molested on July 20th, 2014. You want to tell me here the other side of the story? What other side of the story? What other side of the story? I can tell you when drunkards molested a girl while public watched and the police dithered on July 13, 2014 on the streets of Guwahati. I can go on and on about that case and you'll tell me here the other side of the story. In Rajasthan, a 15-year-old girl fought molesters as bystanders watched and did nothing. And you want me to tell you the most recent case. The most recent case is in Meerut in August 2014. Let's put the pictures out of the screen, please.
In August in Meerut 2014. I don't think this is about
Deepika, it's not between you and me, but you hear the case here. In August 2014, a brave woman single-handedly fought off a dozen goons who were misbehaving with her husband in broad daylight, a crowded place. Shamefully, hundreds of onlookers watched. We have the pictures out there. No one came forward to help the couple. Policemen in Bangalore watched as two girls were slapped and kicked in a police station. And let me tell you, all these cases, including Mr. Muttalik, there would have been no action had the media not picked these cases up. You want me to tell you the other side of the story? I will not let you balance out everything with what you believe is a perceived injustice in the case of Rohtak. Now let Jocelyn speak. And don't tell me what is the difference between molestation and not. Because when a man in broad daylight or on a busy intersection, like this particular person who you are defending tonight, saying, how do you call him a pervert? Let's put his pictures on the screen. You say, how do you call that man a pervert? A man who abuses in a vulgar fashion, repeatedly, a lone woman who is saying something that is right, threatens her in a sexual manner with innuendos, and then says...
Can I please say something here? Then, can I please add something
you can,
here?
Yeah, please, Jocelyn, you can take it forward from here.
Yeah,
Jocelyn,
thank
please,
you.
And let Jocelyn speak.
I'll just make two points here.
Yeah.
First, my answer to your question that why am I already calling him a pervert? If a guy tells me on a busy road, how my genitals are and how and what he will do to my genitals, yes, I will call him a pervert.
Yes,
I will call him a pervert. And second, well, you're telling me that I'm putting him in a putting him in a media trial. No, there's no media trial. I have given. Let me speak now. I'm letting the law take its course. I just filed a complaint. Is it too much to ask for? I have asked for an investigation. I want an investigation to happen. I want to listen to his side of the story.
Listen to me first.
I want to listen from that guy that what made him comment on my genitals or what he would do to me tonight. Why did he have to tell me that on a busy road? Tell me that. Why should I not call him a pervert? Tell me that.
Jacqueline,
I'm sorry I'm getting emotional
because
it was a traumatizing experience and all I did was that I accessed my right and I went up to the police. I put his picture on social media because I wanted to shame this creep. And yes, I will continue to call him a creep because whatever comments he hurled at me, you, Deepika, wouldn't like to hear those things about yourself. I can assure you that. So yes, I will call him a pervert because
Judging your case.
Why are you already calling him a pervert? Yeah, I am answering your question for you. You asked me why are you already calling him a pervert. I'm already calling him a pervert because he told me what he will do to my genitals tonight. Tell me, should I not call him a pervert?
No, Jasleen,
you've spoken enough and I'm now coming in now. You have to now stop it at one. I'm going to some other panelists. I'd like to go to Sophia Ashraf now, Miss Deepika.
There are people who cry.
Miss Deepika, now stop at this point. I'm requesting you. The bigger question is this.
Okay.
Why does a woman? This debate is not about you and me. So I'm putting someone else on air, please.
Please, may I do that?
Miss Deepika, I request you. Now, the fact is this. Why should a woman feel compelled? Why should Jasleen feel compelled to post images of her assaulter on the social media? It is a cry for help. And she's not doing it in an anonymous manner. She's not hiding somewhere. She's not doing this behind a fake Twitter hashtag. She's not hiding her face. I'm so angry today that when that man, who is a pervert, is brought out by the police, there is some kind of a Ku Klux Klan mask put around his face as if it would be embarrassing for the country to see his face. Why should a woman feel compelled? Let's get Sophia into this. To appeal to the public at large to bring her assaulter to book. Why should a police station in many cases not be the first point of recourse for a woman in India? Why should a woman feel apprehensive about filing a complaint? Now, how can this be an indictment of social media? Social media has empowered Jasleen today. Sophia, now we've heard all sides. Sophia Ashraf.
I'm going to play the devil's advocate here. I have faced the nice side of the police also. I think I'd like to bring light to some of those. Outside my college, when women were being groped, the moment I told a police officer about it, that man was apprehended. And we were very happy about it. And till today, this is a case that happened 7 years ago. I still talk about it. But what is sad is we are lauding these people for doing their job. After 7 years, that's the only thing I can talk about. So I need to tell people that what Jasleen has done, it took guts. It's not easy for us to talk about these issues out on social media. The gentleman next to me, he keeps talking about the due course of law. I am completely with you, sir. Yes, we need to follow law, and Jasleen did. I think women need to take a page from her book.
Even I am totally abiding by...
But...
Huh? how am I not abiding by the law? Tell me.
And I always say women should know their law also, and I think that is a fantastic piece that Jasleen has added.
Before law gives a verdict, why should he be shamed?
Well, sir,
because simply because of a man. See, okay. Had it been otherwise, assume that I give you a complaint about a woman. Who listens? Nobody cares.
Well,
the media
sir,
doesn't come in.
Well, sir,
you are already condemned a person before the court could decide his guilt or not. You've already condemned.
Well,
where did he say now?
3 minutes ago, you were telling me about three women who beat up a man.
Yes, it happened.
It happened, right?
Yes.
Haven't you condemned them before the court has decided?
No, nobody has condemned him. No media.
You are condemning.
No,
you are condemning the media.
No, it has happened. Nobody. That's what I'm saying. It has happened. It was there in the news report. And no human cry has been made.
You are making a human cry because you believe in it. This girl is making a human cry.
See, I don't believe the guilt. What I'm saying is, as a victim requires identity protection. The accused also need before he is convicted.
I don't understand your logic, Mr. Suresh. I heard you, Mr. Suresh Ram. Mr. Suresh Ram, you see the point is very. Mr. Ram, I don't understand how this is a men's right issue. The simple fact is this, and Ritwik, I know you've been wanting to come in. I'm coming to you. One second. I'd like to, you know, the fact of the matter is, you know, that people are surprised tonight. There are, Mr. Ram.
354 says the woman only can give you a complaint.
Mr. Ram, listen to me. Can you hear my voice? I just a minute.
Complaint under 354.
Mr. Ram.
He is abused in public.
Mr.
Men are unsafe at home, at streets, at workplace. Who cares?
Honda, may I?
Mr. Ram, if you're going to be on air, I will not be able to go to the others, so hear me for a minute. I'm coming to you, Vikram Singh. There are two issues here.
Yeah.
Lack of faith in the police. Though there are cases in which police acted, Sophia is right, I'm sure there are cases in which police acted. And there are cases in which police act, like in the case of Jasleen, after a fair amount of public attention and the police doesn't want too much attention. But I can assure you, if anyone tells me today the police is the first point of recourse for a woman who is harassed, assaulted, abused, molested or otherwise, there isn't, because the problem is this, and this question goes to Ritwik Basaria, who's a men's right activist, that in this country, if a woman is assaulted, the stigma is on her. If a woman is abused, the stigma is on her. If a woman is molested, the stigma is on her. If a woman is harassed, the problem is hers, not the person who assaults, abuses, molests or harasses. And there are some cases, Mr. Ritwik, some cases like Jasleen's which come in and which strike a chord with people at large, Ritwik. Because here is a woman who says, I'm going to not take this lying down. I thought you would understand what's happening in this country today, but you still seem to have your reservations. What are those, Ritwik?
Ritwik, go ahead. Yeah, the reason I have reservations is because the topic was primarily around putting this on social media. I think what Suresh
what's
and Ritwik, everyone is saying, what everyone is saying is let the investigations happen, let the judgment come, based on that you do it.
Which
before
investigation?
That, I'll tell you the reason, Ritwik, had she
not put this on social media, you want her to go to file a case, go to court, wait 10 years.
Yes, Arnab.
Wait 10 years.
I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. There are 82,200 cases which were filed on 354 last year. Are you saying all these 82,000 were done on social media? No. Secondly, 354, 71% of the cases the accused was not found to be guilty. Are you telling me if those 71% accused were also there on social media and tomorrow they are acquitted, are you telling me who would return their life back? Who would do that?
So you have a law
which does not give a right to a man to do the same thing. I'm not talking specific to Jasleen's case. She has all the right
Sanjay,
to file a complaint, and
okay.
I think she did it. But at the same time, putting it on social media is the problem. How are we calling it? How are we having a debate here today? What probably a court is supposed to do. You are doing an ex parte proceedings here.
Putting pictures online does not mean the court is going to take action against him. It's a social issue.
You're doing an ex parte proceedings. We are already making opinions. We are already making opinions. We are already deciding.
Gee, but this is not. We are not the court.
I am not getting into
we
the
will not decide.
I am saying let's not get into decision making mode now. Let the investigations happen.
We have no power except the one to bring attention to an issue. That's all social media is about.
82,000 cases were filed last year.
Don't throw statistics at me, Mr. Ritwik.
82,000 out of a country of 1 billion. You're telling me only 82,000. That's a joke.
Yes, madam. I am telling you.
Statistically, that's a joke.
Cases which were filed.
Ritwik.
You are saying that police does not do without social media. I am sorry to say police
no, they
did
do,
everything
but
in these 82,000 cases.
Not
you are discussing one
enough.
Case today. Right, 82,000 cases were filed without without the social media also, no?
I think you have completely failed to understand the issue because you are looking at this from a man versus woman prism.
It is
you
not.
Don't understand.
I am talking.
One second. Ritwik, please, now listen, please. You know, the problem is don't get carried away with your own argument. Ritwik, understand, when a woman who has faced a physical threat, and she has. Jasleen has faced a physical threat. He said, file a complaint against me and see what I do to you. This is what he said. When she goes ahead, she files a police complaint, she puts it on social media, she's amplifying her cause. She's also taking the risk that if she were to be uttering a lie, the whole world, including the Indian Penal Code, would be used against her. But she knows she's not wrong. So she defiantly goes out
Arnab,
there. Please, no, Ritwik,
Arnab,
please. Ritwik,
no,
please.
I'm answering to your statement.
Ritwik, one second.
There are thousands of men who get similar threats that if you do something, I will file a rape case on you. Are you telling me that these statements are something which is a gender issue?
Sir, that's
what I'm
saying.
It is
wrong, and I condemn it as much as
how does this become a man?
These are not gender issues.
You're
talking about EFTs, and you're talking about why a woman only has to get this.
You
are
again.
Let it be.
Let's understand that this is a not this
let
is sir this is not
everyone.
A man versus woman debate.
Exactly.
It is
exactly.
A debate on a social
why are
issue
we talking
and let's
only
stick to that.
Why are we only talking that a woman has to go to social media? Are we saying that if a man gets
because,
a threat,
because
it
if
is
I have
okay
an
for
account
to
on social media, I'm fully entitled
like
to post anything
if
that
we do
I want.
That, next date we will be having a debate that how can somebody put a photograph of a woman without her consent on social media? There are so many things which stop a man from doing it. I'm completely in agreement. It is not a man versus woman.
Do you realize
thing.
What has
but
happened? Like I feel like you don't know what has happened in the
is
case.
Based on that it is a woman who's only the sufferer. I am saying crime happens, but then let the crime be gender neutral. Let the reporting be gender neutral.
Yes, it is happening, sir. The proceedings are happening. I am not giving a judgment. He hasn't been sentenced to 3 years or 5 years of jail. I'm not even demanding that.
Jasleen, as a complainant, you have all the right to use.
Don't argue technically. Now, Ritwik, I draw the line now. Okay.
May I just say this to Ritwik?
Ritwik, understand the reality in this country. First of all, if you want to live in an Alice in Wonderland world and pretend that it is men who are equally harassed, men who are equally assaulted, men who are equally molested, right? Men who are raped, men who are assaulted as much as women are. If you believe in this Alice in Wonderland world of yours, then good luck to you.
Let me not give any other data.
Second point, let me now give you a concrete example to prove to you how unfair the situation is to women. There is a lady called Ramona Krasta, okay, from Bangalore. It takes us 6 months for the Delhi police to act against an immigration official who passes the most lewd of comments at her when she's passing through immigration at an airport. It is only after her case and the complaints of police inaction appear in the media that we see concrete action. You ask yourself, why did Jasleen have to go to social media? Why does a woman like Prerna Sharma in Bangalore have to appeal to the Prime Minister of India through the social media after the Bangalore police mocks her when she approaches them to file a complaint after she says she was assaulted, molested and beaten by a mob in broad daylight in Bangalore? The American woman, for your kind information, harassed in Colaba in Bombay, first tweeted the picture of the man who flashed in front of her and only later recorded the statement before the police. Why should we not question the system? You want to balance the argument out by saying men can also be raped. by women. Men can be assaulted, men can be harassed, men can be abused. Yes, they can.
So that's okay. Yeah, but what is the reality? The man, the woman will be punished.
Sir, reality.
What is the reality?
I'm telling you the reality.
Don't give me a technical argument.
Women and Child Development Ministry report in 2007 says
again,
that there are 100 children. No, I'm telling you the data. You want to base it on what you feel. I'm telling you the data.
I am telling you on the basis of facts. Now let's get the others into the debate. Please remember this. I can give you umpteen examples that in this country.
I can give you umpteen number of data, but you're not ready to listen. I'm not saying don't do it for women. Let the man also have the right to complain.
Full on. My question is, do you not acknowledge that we live in a society that is highly patriarchal for all intents and purposes, correct?
Just giving the name of a father to a child is not patriarchal.
I'm telling you, just giving the name of a father to the child doesn't mean patriarcal. So the apathy 53% towards the incidents like this occurring in our country has been so high that we have had to approach social media. Is that social media has served as the bridge between the apathy and the execution for these very actions. The fact that Jasleen's perpetrator is not perpetrator, I won't say anything, the gentleman who abused Jasleen, the fact that he is today in police custody at the speed and rate that he is thanks to social media. So you saying that this is not about men and women. And by the way, in a society where power structures, thank God, are changing, men's discomfort is not men's oppression.
Good point.
You cannot turn it into that. Just remember that the power structures are changing, and Jasleen, people like Jasleen are taking responsibility.
Now it's not between Ritwik and the others. Let's get everyone in, not just four windows on the screen. Please, can I get everyone into the debate now? Ritwik.
Should be served to everybody or only
gender? Why the laws are not gender neutral? If thank God everything is changing, why the laws are not changing?
Just a minute. What is the point, Deepika? There are three panelists have not spoken yet. 38 minutes past 9, I'm being unfair to three panelists. So Deepika, before I come to you, you will appreciate here today that three panelists who are not spoken. Lack of faith in the police is a fact.
Yes, sir.
System works against women is a fact.
Yes.
In 2012, in Kolkata, a 39-year-old woman had to go to court and move the court after a complaint of molestation, not by one, two, three or four. She was molested by five men on a local train. The police says, we are not going to register a case. You go to court. She's molested on a local train. The 39-year-old woman has to go to court. Now, the police respond only after media pressure. There are thousands of cases such as this. I don't know why this becomes a man versus woman issue here. Okay, on the other side, I think I'd like to invite Vikram Singh, please. Vikram, it's not. That's exactly what I'm saying. Vikram Singh, the debate is live on the app. And you can also tell us your point of view. Vikram Singh, regressive mindset that is prevalent among elements in the police or an onlooker mindset among the people, which is bigger? Which is the bigger problem?
Arnab, nothing shocks and surprises me any longer today, and I am returning much wiser after this debate. This concern for the accused by Mr. Ram is so very poignant, and the use of word pervert. Indeed, you are such a thorough gentleman, and you use the Queen's English to use a balanced word for such a pervert. Indeed, use of social media is a force multiplier. And if Jasleen had not done that, the police would just not have reacted. You're absolutely right. And to offer a reward of rupees 5,000 is just to condone for the inaction. The police do not have an action plan. They do not have community policing in place. They do not have an intelligence system of network. They, in fact, should go for the jugular, legally speaking, not illegally. Legally speaking, on all these roadside Romeos and perverts, 1,000 times perverts, and so that they make this country secure for our women folk. The police will have to realize that we too have women in our families, and every victim is an extension of a family, and then and only
all that
then
is okay.
They can
no, no, all that
be
is okay,
a proactive
sir.
Effort.
No, no, Vikram Singh, Vikram Singh, all that is okay. Vikram Singh, it is, I'm sorry to say, I don't really use the Queen's English. You're the first person who's told me that. But no, no, one second, one, just one, one point. The point, Vikram Singh, is this. I don't trust the police. And let me tell you why. It's great the police acted in Jasleen's case. They acted only because they were worried that if the media picks up the story, by tomorrow the commissioner will get a phone call from some politician saying, why aren't you catching this guy? But let me tell you what they did not do. There were other pictures yesterday we played out about drunk policemen on a Delhi metro. Let's play those pictures on the screen, please. Here is a policeman. This is the state of the Delhi police today. This man's Facebook picture, this is the condition he was on a metro. The police says, we can't catch him. We ask the police, why can't you catch him? They say, well, there are many constables and many policemen. God knows who this man is. It was only after the issue became the top headline across the national media for 24 hours. And look at him, he just collapses out there. After this goes 24 hours, and because it went viral on the social media, that the police finally could find this man. Now tell me, after this, I'm expected to have faith in the police. I'm expected to have faith that had Jasleen, Kamal Farooqi and Sanjay Hegde, had Jasleen not gone on social media, I can assure you, and had the mainstream media not picked it up after that, nobody would have caught this man. They would have said, it's a small affair, it happens every day. They would have said, go settle it among yourselves. And if the person does physically attack you tomorrow or assaults you, then you can come back to us and then we might look at this case seriously. This is the reality, Kamal Farooqi. I don't know why some sections are being so defensive about it today. Kamal Farooqi, please. Kamal Farooqi and then Sanjay.
Yes, Arnab, I agree with you. First of all, hats off to my daughter, Jasleen, in fact. She is a proud daughter of all of us because she has the courage to say all those kind of things. And she has been in a position to bring in the culprit to the book, in fact. But I'm ashamed of the people, in fact, 20-25 people were standing over there. And one of their daughters were treated like this. This is really something which Delhi should be ashamed of. Delhi has become a most notorious city as far as the safety and concern of the women folk are concerned. The second thing is, with all my respect to all the people who respect the police, in fact, how the hell police is not taking action against this? That was one of the most busy charaha, in fact, over there. Why the police was not there? Why there have been no CCTV? Why the daughter has to use the media itself? Why they were not in a position to catch it? When we know it, that day in, day out, the girls are being treated like this. Why the police is not frisking the people or having the patrolling, and why not? Because we know it, that the things are going on. And of course, yes, Masjid Jasleen has not has said that Masjid immediately he should be hanged. But she's simply asking proper investigation. And if in the investigation he is found guilty, he should be given the severest kind of punishment. Nobody is going to defend him. But why the police has not taken action at the right time? Why those people have not taken the action at the right time? This is my concern. Why the daughter like Jasleen, in fact, has to raise her voice in the media? And well, media is doing a good job, in fact, that way.
That
yes, we have, gone, we have so got we, certain examples wherein some...
Can we not romanticize the fact that she's the daughter of India? She's the daughter of nobody except her parents. She is a citizen of India, which is why she deserves the protection she deserves and the right to walk on the street and own a public space
that's what
without
I'm saying.
Harassment.
She's my daughter.
So your daughter, ma,
Bene, daughter, in fact.
Please don't do this to romanticize it.
I'm very sad that you are objecting to my this wording also.
Yes,
that shows, in fact,
she's a citizen of India.
You are objecting to calling her the
daughter.
What is your problem then?
Mother. This is ridiculous.
No, she's everybody's daughter. But she is represent. No, I really feel sorry about it. What even for appreciating the girl, you are
you don't
objecting
have to appreciate
to
her. She's
I
fine.
I don't know what
she's
is the point.
She's great. Just say this is what is wrong. Don't
because
make this
she
about,
an example.
Like, this is not
I'm sorry.
A serial.
No,
she
set
serial.
An example. I do
you
not know
what
to mean by all this kind of thing.
No, the point that is being made, and I think Kamal Farooqi, I think you're misunderstanding the point. The point that has been made here is that Jasleen is a very strong woman. She does not need anyone's crutches. She is an exceptionally strong, self-willed and independent young woman and a proud citizen of this country.
And
she
is
not,
why,
you know,
is
one does not need
this. Protecting
no, the
her,
point,
she's,
the point
mother.
That the point that Aditi is making here is that she is not some weak person who needs help, and you know, she is certainly not that. She's the
who's
opposite of that.
Telling?
And I think there
I,
is
I,
and I think
your courage.
I no no I I think today there is, I'm not saying it's you, but I think there is a degree of discomfort at the way in which these strident young women are coming forward, and they really don't give a damn because they know that they live in a country where there is rape, where there is sexual harassment. They live in a city. I don't want to remind you what happened when there was sting operations against policemen, which happened in the Delhi NCR region in 2012, which revealed a deep-seated prejudice among policemen, where very many policemen were caught on record saying that genuine rape victims never approach the police. Those who do have loose moral values, you know, women from the Northeast could never be victims. You know, that, you know, all kinds of, you know, sexist arguments came out when those sting videos had come out. But point tonight is this. This is one case. Today, I feel so proud at what you've done, Jasleen, because I hope that through what you've done, the fear goes down like a chill down the spines of all these perverts. And I will say it again. Because anyone, you can verbally abuse a woman, you can physically abuse a woman. Let's not go into what is abuse and what is not. The fact is somebody did it, and the greatest coward is a person who sits on a motorcycle and thinks he's going to abuse the woman and go away. There's no difference from a person. That person is a potential rapist. Sanjay Hegde, you've heard the other side today. You've heard the other side, men will be affected argument. I want you to respond to those. Sorry to come to you late, by the way, Sanjay, but I think you've comprehensively heard both sides.
I'm being educated.
Yeah, go ahead, Sanjay.
See, the point is this, that no man has a right to abuse. No man had the right to do what that fellow did. But there is also the point that Deepika and the others are doing is the point about fairness. Jasleen was absolutely right insofar as that she felt uncomfortable with going to the police directly. Unless there had
been...
You went to the police, but you were not sure that they would take action until you posted it on Facebook.
Let her speak. She's contradicting you.
I
just got one fact wrong in the sense that she complained first, then she put it up on Facebook. Without that Facebook post, the police would not have taken action.
Yeah.
Absolutely correct. But where there is, might be an issue is this. There is no video of the incident. I so wish that she had put it that at that point a video could have been taken. But that's just
The point I want to make is this.
Just 1 minute, Jasleen. I'm not against you. I'm just summing up the two arguments. The argument is, and this is a real fear among a lot of people, that the next time somebody takes a photograph of you in any situation and says X, Y, Z, and then puts it up on social media, that X, Y, Z will be taken as gospel truth and you can't disprove it. This is where the fairness argument lies. Now, I don't know the answer. It's a difficult proposition.
Okay, so can I give a contrary view to that? My contrary view to that is, and I understand where you're coming from, the argument is that the women could misuse social media, right?
I don't say women. Any sex can misuse it.
Arey bhai, listen to me. Now, you are a lawyer. My information is that as per Section 211 of the Indian Penal Code 1960, if anyone during investigation is found to have made a false claim or a false complaint, there are extremely strong measures within the Indian Penal Code to act against them, including, let me now read out to you, including
sending them to jail.
Term up to 2 years or fine or both, and if such criminal proceeding be instituted on a false charge or an offence. Which means if the person who is making the charge is making a false charge of an offence, punishable with death, imprisonment of seven years for upward, shall be punishable with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 7 years and also likely liable to be fined. So if a person like Jasleen has absolutely done the right thing, but if someone were
Arnab, after
10 years, it has decided who do you think has the energy left to file for a false complaint?
No, if 10 years...
And please don't make this against you.
Sorry, there are more and enough. So there is a law which is there, right? Let the law do
application of the law in this country. You're going back to the Alice in Wonderland world.
You are talking about the data from NCRB. Nobody's pointing on this particular case. We are talking in general and you are taking it so personally for this case. Why is that?
Okay, what?
A person has written a suicide note that he was not at all hurt by the police at all. And there are so many cases like that where people are writing in while dying that they were not hurt at all and they were falsely allegated.
See, there are so many women who have committed suicide after being raped and written letters.
95,000 men are committing suicide. 40,000 women are committing suicide. Data from NCRB, ma'am.
Don't throw data out here.
When you generalize, then data has to be there.
See, the point is you need a fair procedure.
Exactly.
The question is whether social media, instant recourse to social media is fair procedure.
In this that,
there is a question. There is a question to be asked because anybody can allege anything on social media.
Okay, so
and thereafter,
let's look at one case.
How would you bring
Deepika,
the life back once the life is gone?
Deepika, question here. Simple point. Just pull back tonight for a minute. I ask you today. Let's say not Jasleen, any woman walking down the street faces what Jasleen faced with the filth. Right, which she faced, right? She should go back and you are saying wait for a 10-year court process because I know how lower courts, higher courts and higher courts go. And if that person was an influential person with political contacts enough to call the local SHO and say case hi band kara do, then what recourse would a person like Jasleen have? Should she simply say, well, you know, it's terrible. I hope nobody else goes through what I do, but there is a good chance that it will. Here is a person who steps forward and says, I will put myself...
I have a question for you.
FIR cannot be closed.
Does that happen only to women?
Does that happen only to women? Well, it happens to women.
People in this country.
It happens to women.
So I
put this question. If I open the phone lines right now and I specifically asked people in Delhi to respond to this, and let us remember, we are a country where Mulayam Singh Yadav says, can one man commits rape and four more are named? Kabhi aisa ho sakta hai? It's, you know, this is the kind of question that you're asking out here. Aisa practically nahi hai. A person called Mulayam Singh Yadav says gang rape practically nahi hai. Ladke hain, galti to ho jati hai. These are the comments that are made. I find that unbelievable. Now, if I open up the phone lines tonight and I simply ask you a question, I have Jasleen on the other side and you on the other, and simply ask today that let us believe that technically men can also be victims of harassment, molestation, rape, abuse and assault on the streets of Delhi. Technically they can, but who is being harassed, abused, raped, molested on the streets of Delhi? It is women. Right? Now, Mr. Ritwik or you can
please,
get together and say women are not the...
Please don't even misunderstand me.
It is absolutely, we are absolutely talking about generic thing.
She should rise up to
she
it.
She has filed a complaint, which is the right process of the law. We appreciate her for filing a complaint.
Yeah, but nothing would happen to a complaint.
But then at the same time, if you are doing a social media trial, now this is not getting specific to this case.
Can I tell you one thing? This is a country where the great Delhi police did nothing in the Sunanda Pushkar murder case for 1 year, the most high profile case, sat, did nothing, was hoping and hiding perhaps that this issue should not come up in the media. Moment issue comes back in the media, even on that they get active. That's a high profile murder case. Do you think the Delhi police cares for one isolated case? They could not find their own drunk cop for 2 days after his pictures went, until the media put pressure. It's a fact of life. You may not like it. Had Jasleen not gone public with this case, the media would not have taken it up, and after that, the police would not have responded. Now, that's a fact.
Arnab, you can
deny the reality. I don't agree with you.
In 2014, 1 lakh people were arrested in 354. Let me tell you, all these 1 lakh people were not arrested after a Facebook post.
Is that it? 1 lakh people? You must be
joking.
Were
arrested.
Every day we live our lives, and people on this panel can confirm it's not only 1 lakh people.
Let me tell you, it includes few women also.
Should I take a break? I'll take a break. Before I take a break, I want to tell you. I'll read out a quote, and I'll give this audience, including you, Mr. Ritwik, 3 minutes to tell me whose quote it was. There is a person who says, "You cannot drive alone at 2 o'clock in the morning on Delhi's roads and then claim that the capital is unsafe. You should always take your brother or a male driver with you. These are reasonable precautions expected to be taken by all citizens in the city." Now, 3 minutes from now, question goes to all viewers of NewsHour also. You can use that hashtag, and I'll put out few correct replies when I come out on the other side. No, don't give the answer away. Who is the person who said that? You won't believe it when I tell you who the person is. I'm coming back in a couple of... By the way, Jasleen, let me tell you, so many people calling right now wanting to congratulate you on all their behalf. I congratulate you before I go into a break. I'll see you on the other side. We're extending this. Before I went into the break, I read out a quote where a person says, "You cannot drive alone at 2 o'clock in the morning on Delhi's roads and then claim that the capital is unsafe. You should always take your brother or your male driver with you. These are reasonable precautions that are expected to be taken by all citizens of the city." I don't give prizes on the program, but anyway, if you knew it, the right answer for that is BK Gupta, Delhi Police Commissioner, commenting on the increasing number of rape cases. July 2011 was a controversial quote at that point of time. Now, I don't think Jasleen's doing this, you know, just to make a point. Why do you think she did it? Aditi, let me come to you, and let's go back to the root issue. Why do you think she did it?
Jen, I think actually we are technically, all of us are on the same side of the debate, and the side of the debate is that, you know what, we are not being listened to.
Yeah.
We are, the level of apathy is so high that we have to look for, you know, attention. We have to look for redemption. We have to look for justice in the strangest of places. And unfortunately, it's coming true.
Absolutely.
Is that we are getting justice when we are posting on
Sophia,
social media.
Sophia, what do you think?
Yes, I think today the debate has kind of segued into a gender debate. What I'd like to say is, Aditi and me, we are all on the same side. Sir, if a man is being raped, if a man is being abused, we would still come up with the same kind of uproar. I think the reason for this particular picture going viral is because India is on the brink of a revolution. People are tired now. Women,
right,
men, everyone alike are just tired of taking this. So we are ready to speak out. So it's not a gender debate. If it were a man, if it were a male friend of mine who had lewd comments posted about him, I would say, complain to the police and then take to social media and we will have your back.
But
and that's what we're saying.
But the law is not like that. We have brought a feminist and...
Let it speak.
A man cannot even go and complain at all.
Who says?
That is not being condemned by anyone.
Who says? Where?
They're in the law.
By which law?
They're in the law.
Don't misread the law.
Can I speak on the law?
Watch out. Okay. Member of the All India Men's Welfare Association, Suresh Ram, you are getting a response from Sanjay Hegde. Yes, please. He says men have no recourse. Only women have all rights in our law.
No. The point is slightly different.
Yes.
A man can't be raped under the law. Even 354, these are laws which are designed to protect women. That doesn't mean that the law is gender neutral in that sense. But the point is that men face a different kind of problem. Please.
Can be committed against men.
No.
You read 354. If 354 is about rape, if that definition is
354 is about molestation,
that can be straight away used against a man. Verbal abuse, stalking.
Yes. I get what you're saying, sir. I'm on that rare side that I'm on.
It is not applicable to men.
I'm in that rare position where I tend to agree with both sides.
Well, let me tell you. No. Let me tell you about mindsets.
Mindsets.
Let me share something.
I agree with Aditi. I agree with Aditi that there is a great deal of patriarchy in society.
Sir, can I tell you how great?
But can the answer to patriarchy is not a reverse kind of reservation against men.
Okay. Himachal.
Or a campaign against
Himachal
men.
Pradesh.
That's
Himachal
fear.
Pradesh
that's
High Court.
That's where the fear is.
No, Suresh, Mr. Hegde, Sanjay Hegde, the Himachal Pradesh High Court. Hear this, please. This is a gem.
Yeah.
What I'm now going to share with you is a real gem. And I'm sorry if the High Court is going to be upset in Himachal Pradesh for it. But I completely disagree with what they said. This Himachal Pradesh High Court very recently. Anyway, I'm outspoken enough. I don't care if, the courts don't like what I'm saying. But the fact is this. The Himachal Pradesh High Court observes, no doubt it is the responsibility, few days back, moral and ethical both on part of a man not to exploit any woman by compelling or inducing her for sexual relationship. But it is ultimately the woman who is the protector of her own body. Therefore, the woman's prime responsibility is to ensure that in a relationship, her own dignity and her own modesty is protected. Now I continue, this is what the court says. A woman is not expected to throw herself to a man and indulge in promiscuity, thereby becoming a source of hilarity. It is for the woman to maintain her purity. It is for the woman to maintain her chastity. It is for the woman to maintain her virtues. Quoted in the Indian Express, Himachal Pradesh High Court a few days back. It's a court says this.
Well...
Now look at that, look at me, and Mr. Ram agreeing with it. Mr. Ram agreeing with it. No, this is the problem. This is the mindset.
There are cases like this that have happened. There are cases like this that have happened where there is a married woman, where there is a married woman who has had a...
There are cases where marital rape is not even being acknowledged legally. So it's tough.
Madam,
it's awful for both genders. The system we are living in is not
Deepika and Aditi.
There are four sections which are all...
Only Deepika and Aditi.
Things are not fair on both sides. Things are not fair on both sides. For every case that you state, unfortunately, there are about 1,000 on this side as well. So that's not the crux of the argument.
Wait a minute. If Arnab chooses to pick up a judgment... If Arnab chooses to pick up a judgment, then he should go into the details of a lot many judgments that are coming.
I'm quoting an observation.
The Delhi court also said
what's wrong?
That we cannot go by emotions. We cannot. No, there's nothing wrong.
Where is the emotion here?
Where is the emotion?
You're just stating another one for like no other reason except
Nivedita
one was
Anil Sharma. Nivedita Anil Sharma in Delhi, a female judge said that people who are honorably acquitted in the rape cases, should they be called rape case survivors as well?
That's like syntax, like, that's
that.
Dynamics. What does that mean?
And my plea to you today is, tomorrow if there is a case that comes to you where a man has been honorably acquitted, would you do a show on that?
Absolutely. I mean, I don't understand your argument.
Yeah,
here. You begin by Rohtak. We can go on and on. We can go on. I think the fact is this.
No, it's not.
No, you are not understanding the issue.
It's not driven
in
by
this,
Rohtak.
You are not understanding. You are now choosing not to look at it.
Arnab, jo karega ab tak khud ke show par tu bata yaar, what are we talking about? What is the debate about?
The issue is this. I'm practically looking at it. There is a problem in our country. There is genuine harassment. I mean, we all know how difficult it is, and these complaints don't come from Delhi for nothing. Now, this case becomes all the more important because Jasleen faced this in the heart of Delhi. And also, Jasleen, let me tell you why so many people you may be thinking are responding in this manner to you. I'll tell you clearly today, Jasleen, because there are a lot of people who may feel that it may be hurting Jasleen what she went through. But I'm sorry, there are a lot of people, Jasleen, who will feel, ye to hota hai. Itni badi baat kya, you know, that whole response of our society.
I want to refer to the persons exactly to take that point forward. I want to refer to the person I have accused, that the gentleman that I have accused of hurling sexually abusive remarks at me. his father, what he said in his statement is, aise hi rai ka pahad bana rahe hain. What is this rai and what is this pahad? Obviously, it's an analogy stating that rai is making obscene remarks and pahad is rape. So what if I have a problem with the rai? What if I want to nip thee even in the bud? Is it too much to ask for? Is it really that big a deal? Yes, I want to nip the evil in the bud, and yes, I'm not okay with anyone making obscene remarks at me in public or privately or wherever. I am just not okay with it. I'm not going to take it. That's it. That's what I feel. How is it even problematic? I haven't. You're talking about social media trial. I'm not even talking about a social media trial here. The law is taking its course. If you're accusing me of the fact that I have taken law into my own hands, no, I didn't start beating that person. I could have slapped that person there itself. No, I did not, because that would have been the wrong thing to do. I approached the police. I followed procedure. So how is this? How am I taking law into my own
Justine,
hands?
If I can answer that.
No,
see, yes, you picked a very good example. If you had slapped him right there and then.
Yeah.
Most possibly, thereafter, if you had taken it to the police station, the police would have congratulated you. Because why? They didn't have to then file an FIR. Things got sorted out among themselves. And nothing needs to be done. Now what you have done. See, there is a problem. Today, you have done it in the right cause. Equally,
No, don't balance it. No, please. Yeah. Sanjay, what you are trying very hard. No, Sanjay, I've heard you. I've heard you, Sanjay.
That if
you're repeating the
answer to a bad situation is not to make the law worse.
No, one second.
No, that's exactly the danger.
Sanjay, listen.
That's exactly the danger.
Sanjay, listen. Now, one simple point. I'm closing the debate. It's a very interesting point. We can take this forward. First of all, on behalf of everyone here at Times Now and many of our panelists, I congratulate you. And on behalf of a lot of people out there who support you, I think you deserve a standing ovation from people today simply for doing what you did. And this, what you said, Rai Ka Pahad, mountain of a molehill argument, because you have basically sent a message today, Jasleen, that it is not okay to molest, assault, verbally abuse, tease, or do anything. It's not okay. And there will be people with antediluvian 18th century mindsets who will say Rai Ka Pahad. But there are some people on the streets, principally that character, that pervert, who felt it was his birthright to abuse any woman on the streets of Delhi. But it is not her right to take him on. You've proven that wrong. You have changed the power equation. You are truly an agent of change, Jasleen. You may not realize the smallest of instances have sometimes an epic importance in the changing fabric of our society and the way society responds to things like this. And I'm so proud of you, Jasleen. I'm sure your family is, and I personally am, and I think a lot of people are. So more power to you, and thank you for joining us on our Fight Back India debate right on top of NewsHour this evening. Thank you, Jasleen.
Thank you.